Welcome to Academic Game Tutorials. In this video, we will discuss about the construction details of a shaper machine, along with the operation of different parts that together construct a shaper machine and the driving mechanism that runs the shaper machine. So, let's get into the topic. A shaper machine is one of the most common machine tools that is seen in the mechanical workshops and in the manufacturing industries. A shaper is a machine that uses the reciprocating motion of a single point cutting tool to perform the various machining operations. It is a machine tool that produces flat, horizontal, and vertical surfaces on the workpiece. Now, let's look at the construction details of a shaper machine and the operation of different parts that together construct a shaper machine. First of all, we have a base for the shaper machine. This base is attached to the concrete floor and is the most bottom portion of the shaper machine. All of the other parts are mounted on the base. Thus it holds the shaper machine in its place firmly. It is a very strong part of the machine which can bear the weight of the whole machine. The base of the shaper machine is made of cast iron, through the casting process. Since cast iron has a high compressive strength, high shock absorbance, and wear resistance capacity, so it helps the base to absorb the vibration during work and transfer to the ground. Above the base, there is column of a shaper machine attached to this base. This column acts as a housing for all the gear mechanisms, driving pulleys, and other mechanisms required to run the shaper machine. So, the column holds all the gears, pulleys, connections, and all related driving mechanisms inside of it. Now, on this side, and above the column, there are two guideways attached. This guideway on the side guides the work table in the reciprocating movement up and down. And this guideway above the column guides the ram of shaper machine in the reciprocating movement forward and backward. Here, on this side, there is a support or guide. It is called work table sliding support. From the name we can understand that it supports the table during upward and downward sliding movement. In between this work table sliding support and the guideways, there is the work table over here. The work table generally has a box-shaped structure, and on the top surface there are T-slots cut on the work table. These T-slots are provided so that any type of machine vise can be easily set on the table, and the machine vise sits firmly on the table due to these T-slots. Over here, there is a hand traversing wheel, which is used to elevate this work table upwards or downwards. We can also call it as an elevating hand wheel. Above the table, there is a machine vise. Or we can simply call it vise. The vise is used to clamp or hold the job firmly between its two jaws so that the job remains in position tightly throughout the shaping operation. It has two jaws. This one is a fixed jaw, and this one is a movable jaw. There is a handle given with the vise, using which we can move this movable jaw front and back. And thus a job of any given size can be fitted firmly within these two jaws using this handle. Up here, above the column, there is the ram of the shaper machine. This ram can move forward and backward sliding on these guideways above the column. Connected to the ram, here we have a ram clamp. This ram clamp is used to set the position of the ram before starting the shaping operation. Here, there is scaling or graduation, which helps the ram clamp in positioning the ram accurately before starting the operation. Connected to the ram, there is a swivel base on the front side. It is a circular structure. There are scales or graduation on this swivel base. These scales are given in the measurement of angles. And connected to the swivel base there is a tool head, or we can also call it a vertical slide. It can move upward or downward vertically. Also, this tool head can be rotated or swiveled to any angles with the help of these degree scales cut on the swivel base. There is a hand wheel given on the top of it. Using this handle, this tool head or vertical slide can be moved upward and downward and give the required feed to the cutting tool. And these scales cut in angles helps in rotating or swiveling to any angle according to requirements. After that, there is a clapper box connected to this tool head. This clapper box holds the tool post and the single point cutting tool sitting on it. Now, here attached to the clapper box there is the tool post. The tool post holds the cutting tool firmly throughout the whole shaping process. And a single point cutting tool is mounted on the tool post. Just like lathe machine, shaping machine also uses single point cutting tool. The difference between the two is that the lathe machine gives us a helical cut, while the shaper machine gives us a linear cut. Usually, this single point cutting tool is made out of HSS or high-speed steel, but can be made out of high carbon steel also. Here on the ram, there is a stroke positioning hand wheel. Using this, the position of stroke of the ram is changed, thus cutting tool stroke position is also changed with the ram by using the stroke positioning hand wheel. And at last, down here we have a cross-feed hand wheel. This cross-feed hand wheel is used to give a crosswise movement to the work table. That is, let's take for reference, if this elevating hand wheel moves the work table up and down, then this cross-feed hand wheel moves this work table towards front and back, that is cross-motion is obtained. So, since this wheel gives cross-movement or perpendicular movement, so, it is called cross-feed hand wheel. Now let's look how shaping operation takes place in a shaper machine. When this elevating hand wheel is rotated, the work table moves upward and downward. Above the work table, machine vise is attached through T-slots. And workpiece is fixed inside the vise using this handle. So, when this elevating hand wheel is rotated, the work table moves upward and downward along with the machine vise and the job fixed on it. So, we can move our job up and down and bring it to the desired height for the shaping process. Then using this cross-feed wheel, job is brought to required position. And here, this ram moves forward and backward. There is a crank and lever mechanism inside this column which converts the rotational movement of the gears inside the column into reciprocating or linear movement of the ram, thus the ram moves forward and backward. The single point cutting tool is connected to the ram, so the tool also moves forward and backward with the ram, and when feed is given using this tool head, then the tool comes in contact with the workpiece while moving forward and backward, and thus removes material from the workpiece in each stroke. Now, let's understand how the crank and slotted lever mechanism, or the driving mechanism placed inside this column works to run the shaping operation. First, let's look into the parts that construct the driving mechanism of the shaper machine. Here, we have a crank mounted on a base, and meshed to it we have a driving gear. On the crank, there is a pin that rotates with the crank when the crank rotates. Here we have a lever which is slotted open on the inside. Inside the slot of the slotted lever, this pin is adjusted. And the lever is pivoted on one end with this base. These are all positioned inside the column. And above the column, we have the ram housing where the ram is situated. Inside the ram housing, there is a sliding block or sliding link. This sliding block and the slotted lever is connected through this link. So, first of all, this driving gear is connected to the motor through a pulley system or a belt system. When the machine is turned on, and motor switch is started, the driving gear starts rotating, and meshed to the driving gear, this crank also starts rotating. The pin rotating the crank is also locked inside this slotted lever, so the pin rotates with crank and slides inside the slotted lever. Now, the lever is pinned here with base, so when the pin slides inside the slotted lever, the lower portion of lever remains fixed, but the upper portion of the lever starts moving backward and forward. Since the slotted lever is connected to the sliding block situated inside this ram housing through this link, so, this connecting link and the attached sliding block also moves backward and forward when this slotted lever moves backward and forward. Now, when this sliding block moves backward and forward inside the ram housing, the ram also moves backward and forward with this sliding block, and thus shaping operation takes place as long as the driving mechanism inside the column is functioning. So, we have learned the construction details of a shaper machine, along with the detailed operation of different parts and the driving mechanism of shaper machine. If this video was helpful, subscribe to my channel Academic Game Tutorials on YouTube for more updated videos. Thank you.